compensation fund for victims of child sexual abuse. Even if the abuse happened decades ago, our attorneys can file a claim for you and get you the justice and closure you deserve while you remain completely anonymous. If you've suffered abuses from scout leaders and those who knew about the abuse but failed to stop it, call our law firm's confidential scout abuse helpline at 800-824-2387, as you may be entitled to substantial compensation. But hurry, as time is running out to file a claim. Call 800-824-2387 right now. If you are eligible for substantial compensation, call 800-824-2387. That's 800-824-2387. 800-824-2387.
Right now we've got 59 degrees at Metro Airport. How's the weekend, the Labor Day weekend, shaping up? Details here to have.
Direction. Again, that's 8 miles at Telegraph Road. Senator Dennis Neubacher, WWJ News Radio 950.
With a look now at your WWJ AccuWeather forecast. Let's check in with Dave Samuel from the Bill Brown Ford Weather Center.
The rest of today will feature plenty of sunshine. Temperatures will be comfortably cool. A high of only 74 out there, humidity low. But the clear sky for tonight with a low of 55. Some suburbs could dip into the 40s, much like they did this morning. For tomorrow, partly sunny skies, a high 76. Sunday, increasing clouds and windy with a shower or thunderstorm possible in the afternoon. 25. Partly sunny Monday, breezy and warmer with a high of 82. Small chance for another thunderstorm. Tuesday looks warm with highs in the mid-80s. This is AccuWeather meteorologist Dave Samuel on WWJ News Radio 950.
All right, appreciate it, Dave. We got temperatures pretty cool on this Friday morning, but they'll warm up to a pretty nice day today. At Metro Airport right now, we got just about 67 degrees. There, actually, don't make that 59 degrees. It's pretty cool. 59 degrees will eventually again get to a high of 74.
Live and local, News Radio 950, WWJ.
Good morning, I'm Kathleen Talley.
And I'm John Jordan. These are the top stories. Unemployment dropped to 8.4% last month, down from 10.2% in July. CBS News business analyst Joe Schlesinger says many of those who have jobs, they're working differently.
The Labor Department also asked workers whether or not they were working from home. 24.3% said they are still working due to the virus.
Over a million jobs were added in the month of August.
There have been three straight nights of drive-by shootings on one Ypsilanti Township street. Two suspects in custody this morning. We've got the full story at 9:30.
A Northern Oakland County man is behind bars after calling 911 and confessing to killing his girlfriend. The Sheriff's Department says the 50-year-old man was standing in his driveway on the Springfield Township when a deputy arrived and said, I killed her. The suspect's 16-year-old girlfriend was found dead inside their home. She was shot several times. A handgun was found in the basement.
The burial ground of one of the Confederacy's best-known leaders is getting a new name. CBS News correspondent Jim Cardillo tells us about it.
Lexington, Virginia City Council members, including Dennis Ayers, approved a motion
which will rename Stonewall Jackson Memorial Cemetery as Oak Home Cemetery.
Confederate General Stonewall Jackson owned slaves and fought to defend that right. He was buried in the cemetery not far from the Virginia Military Institute more than 150 years ago. Jim Crisula, CBS News.
Hey, guys, check you out on Midday News anchor Brooke Allen joining us right now. We'll look at what's coming today with Brooke Allen. Hi, Brooke Allen.
Hey, I'm Brooke Allen. Well, this is going to be a very different kind of Labor Day weekend for car shoppers and car dealers. WWJ's auto reporter Jeff Gilbert will explain. On the campaign trail, Joe Biden campaigns in Delaware today. We'll have coverage. And one of my favorite things, cider mills, they're opening in the Franklin Cider Mill. Different because of COVID. We will be getting some answers during a live interview that happens at 11:30. Also, some Detroit police officers are moving up the ranks. We'll have that. And here's a question for you. Are you sleeping in a sea of bacteria? You may be surprised. That and traffic and weather together on the 8th as we get into between 10 and 2.
Sounds wonderful. Thank you, Brooke Allen. We're going to check in with Ed Corey in the moments ahead.
I'm Mark Tapper, and a good portion sale at Tapper's Jewelry is drawing to a close. I'm Sir Richard Washington, and the very idea of a sale offends my delicate sensibilities. What's wrong, Sir Richard? Don't like lower prices on something beautiful? I get satisfaction from overpaying. Keeps me, what's the opposite of humble? Pretentious? Yes, exactly. At Good Fortune Sale, you'll save anywhere from 22 to 50% off nearly every regular priced item in the store. Ridiculous. And starting mid-August, we lower prices even more to clear out last year's design. Selection's a little smaller, but prices are even lower. Silly games for silly people. Fun, and we have cookies. Silly food. Pull yourself together, madam. Come on, Sir Richard. Enjoy yourself. Enjoyment is overrated. Good Fortune Sale is extended until Labor Day. Only at Tapper's Jewelry. Bloomfield, Nova, and Troy. CDW will get water service. Need to be flexible, scalable, and predictable. I predicted you'd say that.